a series of 16th century Franciscan frescoes uncovered at the convent in 2004 are currently being restored. The programme of conservation and recording will peel away centuries of overpainting and historical amnesia, with those involved extremely excited with the project.
Unfortunately, they're in quite a bad state, and they're in quite a bad state for a number of reasons. One, basically the history of Gibraltar has not been kind to them. Gibraltar has suffered since, these are Spanish frescoes, so since the Spanish period has suffered a certain number of sieges, especially the Great Siege wrought quite a lot of destruction in this area of town. And the fact that after they were painted over in the early British period, people forgot that these things were there. I mean, they were behind a whitewash wall. So unfortunately, they're in a poor state, but they're still recoverable.
Although fresco fragments have been discovered in the cathedral, the convent find is pretty special, with the paintings not just decorative in nature, but depicting specific saints of the Franciscan order, another Christian iconography, mainly two local martyrs.
Martyrs that died for trying to spread Christianization into North Africa. This served really as what would have been the old refectory, so you can almost imagine the abbots and the novices sitting around with these frescoes all around them. This would have served as inspiration for the young novices to go out into the world and evangelize and bring the word of God. In that sense, they're unique in Gibraltar. They're also quite rare to find in the rest of the Iberian Peninsula. The reason for that being that because these were painted over by the British, although because it was at the time blasphemous and so forth, that to a certain extent has preserved them, even given all sort of the variances of time and so forth. So they're quite unique for Gibraltar, definitely unique and very, very interesting for me.
The discovery was in fact made during general works as the walls were being replastered. The restoration is expected to take around 3 months to complete, but there's a chance there's still more to be discovered.
We hope to be able to at least survey the other parts of the room to see whether any frescoes survive in them. And that could be at a later stage. We could look, if indeed there are frescoes, we could look at that as a second stage in the project further down the line.
The project is jointly managed by the Heritage Trust and the Ministry for Heritage, with Ainhoa Rodriguez undertaking the restoration itself.
Well, it's going to mean a great deal. This is very much our history. Gibraltar, as we know, went through the Moorish period, the Spanish period, and now we're discovering parts of the Spanish period and how the religious aspect of the whole of the Iberian Peninsula could have developed from here.
I think this is just another illustration of how uniquely significant Gibraltar has been in the progression of human civilization and affairs. This was the outreach program of Christianity 500 years ago, reaching into North Africa to evangelize that part of the world. And as I look today and I look forward, I think maybe more in the economic domain than a religious domain, but it shows me how Gibraltar can and has reached out for the greater good of the region and the greater good of Gibraltar. So I think, as Churchill says, the further you look back in history, the further you can look forward into the future. And I think the fascinating, significant find of these frescoes very much illustrates that.
The frescoes are expected to form an integral part of the convent tours in future, bringing an element of Gibraltar's history to life.